So we need to do policy iteration. So shall we? Or should we not? I mean, we started late, I know it's my mistake. Huh? Here. Oh, okay. So that leaves us 15 minutes, eh? Okay, we could do it in 15 minutes. So policy iteration, the idea is very simple, right? So I start off with some arbitrary policy, let us say pi naught, right? I start off with some arbitrary policy pi naught, I find v pi naught, right? Then what do? I be greedy with respect to v pi naught, I will find pi 1, right? So being greedy is this, right? So I will take some pi naught, solve, find v pi naught, right? Then do this and I will find pi 1. Right, and then I will find v pi 1, plug that back in here, right. So essentially I will plug in v n here, find pi n plus 1, right. So keep going until I converge, and convergence here is more straightforward. If you stay with the same policy, you converge, right. And usually convergence is much faster, the rate of convergence is much faster with policy iteration, but yeah, for variety of reasons, value iteration remains a very favorite algorithm for many OR people, right? So they don't like policy iterations for some reasons. So, but people get the idea of what a policy iteration is, right? You can go implement policy iterations, rather easy, right? So, first, select some arbitrary. I hate going back and forth. Select an arbitrary pi naught, right? Second step is called policy evaluation. So where you say where you find v pi naught policy evaluation, I just find v pi n, right? So we can just do this by solving those system of equations. I can just take the inverse of that matrix and solve it, right? Or if you like it, you could do the iterative fashion, just like you did in value iteration. Instead of iterating on L, I can iterate on L pi, right? And then I will have to have some stopping criterion for stopping it, but I can do this as well. Next thing is, it's called policy improvement. Okay, this is the second step is called policy evaluation, third step is called policy improvement. Just like we mentioned earlier, so the marg max is done component wise, right? For every state, yes, you do the max. It's just whatever I wrote here before I erased it, right, at the beginning, right? Exactly that. The only difference is here I am plugging in v pi n, right? This is not v star, right? So this is v pi n, and I do this arg max over pi, and at every step, because I am checking for equality for stopping, right? So there could be multiple actions that give you the max here, right? So if at step n you chose an action for giving a max, right? So step n, there is some action you have chosen as policy for a state S. In step n plus 1, if the same action belongs to the max set, you will pick that action only. You don't pick an arbitrary action from the max set. Suppose let us say going up and going right, right? Both are optimal, right? But in the previous step I had chosen going up for the state. This step I should choose going up also, right? Otherwise I will just keep oscillating between up and right, up and right. I might not figure out that I have stopped, right? So I shouldn't choose an action from the maximizes randomly, right, or arbitrarily. I have to have some mechanism by in which I consistently break ties so that policies don't change when they don't have to. So pi n plus 1 if is equal to pi n, stop and declare that pi n is pi star. Otherwise go to, well, otherwise increment n and go to step 2, okay? So it's rather easy. Right? So if the stopping condition holds, can you see why pi n should be pi star? That doesn't mean anything, it just means it's a fixed point. Why pi n should be pi star? Well, it is a fixed point, but it's a fixed point of L. If you think about it, max over pi, r pi plus gamma p pi v pi, right? I mean, that operation, that looks like L. That's L operating on v pi. Right? And if I get back pi n, the same v pi, same pi again, right? So that means the value function hasn't changed. Right, so that means V equal LV. So that means it's the optimal value function. Right, so if pi n equal to pi n plus 1, because of the way I am generating the sequence of pi's, and if pi n equal to pi n plus 1, then pi n is pi star.
Pi n plus 1 equals to pi n, the underlying value function haven't changed. That's why
also haven't changed, right? Because the policy hasn't changed, then the value function wouldn't have changed.
That's why we are saying it's pi star.
No, because of the way we are generating here, right? I mean, so if the value function hasn't changed, and this is essentially, this part of it is essentially L operating on V pi, and it hasn't changed. So that essentially means that it is the optimal value function. Okay. And what else do we need to show? I said if pi n equal to pi n plus 1, then pi n is v star, pi n is pi star, is a pi star, by the way, right? What else do we have to show?
That
I have to show that happens, right? I'll have to show that happens. So we'll do that in two ways. One, we'll have to show that, so v pi n plus 1 will be greater than or equal to v pi n, right? So why is that? Huh? No, why you think that will be greater? So basically pi n plus 1 is a greedy policy according to v pi n, okay? So I have taken v pi n and acted greedily with respect to it, and I get pi n plus 1. So that is what I mean. Let pi n plus 1 satisfy 3, then this is clear, right? So, because pi n plus 1 satisfies 3, so that is being greedy with respect to Vn. Well, pi n is some arbitrary policy. If it is the same as this, then that will give the same answer, otherwise this will be greater, because this is the one obtained by maximizing this expression, right? I took this expression, I am maximizing it, and whatever gives me the maximum, I am saying is pi n plus 1, right? So this is the maximum on the left hand side. So the maximum has to be greater than or equal to whatever value I will get by plugging in some other pi n here, okay, because this is the max, okay, this is clear, right?
Just one more step.
So I can say R so why can I say this? Because this is actually equal to Vn. Right hand side will be equal to V pi n, because it is a fixed point of L pi. So this is L pi operating on V, L pi n operating on L, V pi n. So it is a fixed point. So this is V pi n. So essentially this is it. And if I multiply both sides by what do I get? So that into this is what? So every step I will keep improving, okay. So the last bit we need is to show that there are only a finite number of policies that you can search through if you are having a finite MDP, finite number of deterministic policies. We are searching through only deterministic policies here. There are only a finite number of deterministic policies you can search through if you have a finite MDP. So that is basically, you have proved it. So policy iteration will converge, but every time I have to become better. And there are only a finite number of things I can search through. At some point, so I will have to stop. What is that? Okay, the component wise. So every component of V is greater than, sorry, I didn't define it earlier, I should have. So this essentially means that Vn plus 1 of S1 is greater than or equal to Vn of S1 of S2, S3 for all S. Right? I think there are people clamoring to come in, so that's why I stopped. We can go out and you can ask questions.